Good morning, children. How are you all? I think today we are all fine, sure. My dear children, now we are going to read Unit 3, School Life, from that reading A. Swami is expelled from school. Swami is expelled from school. This is a reading. Children, had you given punishment by your teacher any time? Last year or before last year? Yes. Yes, some are saying. Yes, you had that bitter experience. My dear children, now I'm going to share the screen. I'm going to share the screen. We have to look at the screen. We have to look at the screen. Hey, Nazir. Dear children, I'm going to share the screen. Yes, here, my dear children. Now you have to look at the picture, or if you have a textbook, you have to open the page number 46. Yes, children, now you are looking at the picture. What do you observe in the picture? See carefully and observe the picture, and we have to say, a teacher is twisting the ears of a boy in the class, isn't it? Yes, it's clear. A teacher is twisting the ears of a boy in the class. The boy may be committed a mistake, so the teacher is trying to give punishment in the class. Here, the boy is getting tears from his eyes. Is it? Yes, see clearly. A drop of tears is coming out from his eyes. Dear children, this is a very familiar experience to all. It's common in our classroom. So, once again, we have to look at the picture carefully and get ready to give answer. The first question, do you agree with the action? Do you agree with the action of the teacher as depicted in the picture? Give at least one reason for your opinion. My dear children, do you support, at least do you agree with the action? What's going in the picture? Yes, some are saying. My dears, among you, some are saying, no, I don't agree with the active action of the teacher as depicted in the picture. Why don't you agree? The reason, you may say, corporal punishment or physical or verbal punishment is not suggested nowadays. Yes, my dear children, nowadays we should not support verbal punishment. According to psychology, giving harsh, corporal or verbal punishment is not correct. Psychology doesn't agree giving punishment, and it hurts the students. Yes, the giving punishment hurts the students. The students may get disappointed and they may lose interest towards studies. They may fall away from schools, and they may stop coming to schools, and they may remain as dropouts in our schools. Yes, we will have a big problem of dropouts. So we should ban or eradicate the corporal punishment or physical or verbal punishment. Okay, I think I expect this answer from you surely. And let's move to the second question. Suggest ways of maintaining discipline that don't involve physical or verbal abuse. Dear children, what are the ways we have to follow to eradicate, to stop this type of verbal or harsh punishments in our classrooms? My dears, here, by saying clearly what they did and what are the impacts, I mean consequences of their actions, we should explain with the utmost patience, and we have to make clear the consequences of bad activities, and we should clear how it's a loss for their bright future and for their career. We should guide them properly, and we have to give a clear way, the way which they have to follow. And we should explain the impacts of discipline in life. Yes, what is the main motto of discipline? What is the importance of discipline? And we may take some examples of great personalities, national leaders, or some inspiring, igniting leaders like Abdul Kalam Azad, how they had the discipline and how they had achieved their goals with the help of discipline. Like that, we have to take a number of illustrations and we have to make clear the importance and the motto of the discipline, but not giving corporal punishment. So, my dear children, this is about the face sheet, and you are looking at the picture, and with the help of that you can understand easily that's a classroom and there were students and there is a ma'am, and ma'am is teacher is giving punishment, and teacher is twisting the ears of the boy, and teacher is asking something, and the boy is trying to give explanation or answer. This is about that face sheet, my dears. And my dear children, now we have to move to a reading. Swami is expelled from school. Here, it's a similar experience what we saw, what we have seen just now from the picture. It's a similar, same experience of Swami, how Swami is expelled from school, and about that a reading. So, my dear, if you have a textbook, we have to open the textbook and look at the page number 47. Otherwise, I'm going to share the screen of our textbook of 47 page number. You have to look at the screen, my dears. Yes, now it's very clear, my dears. Swami is expelled from school. This is the given a reading. Let's read. The headmaster entered the class with a slightly flushed face and a hard, ominous look in his eyes. Here, it's a classroom. There are students and there is headmaster. The headmaster entered the class with a slightly flushed face and a hard, ominous look in his eyes. Here, the situation of the headmaster is described with the help of flushed and ominous words. So let me clear the meaning of flushed. The word flushed is acting as an adjective, which means red and hot. The face with the serious, it is describing the serious face of the headmaster. And the ominous, it's an adjective. It means suggesting that something bad is going to happen. Yes, in his eyes, it's coming out the feeling something is going to be happened bad, ominous. So, my dear children, the headmaster entered the class with a slightly flushed face and a hard, ominous look in his eyes. Particularly, yes, a ominous look, a peculiar look in his eyes. Swaminathan wished that he had been anywhere but there at that moment. The headmaster surveyed the class for a few minutes and asked. The headmaster has been observing the class keenly. Surveying means observing cleanly the class. And asked, Are you not ashamed of coming? Dear children, are you not ashamed of coming and sitting there of what you did yesterday? Aren't you ashamed of that? You did something yesterday. Because of that, aren't you ashamed of him? Just a special honor to them. He read out the names of a dozen students so that had attended the class. Here, the headmaster is reading out a dozen students' names who were attended. And after that, he read out the names of those that had kept away and asked them to stand on their benches. Yes, here headmaster is giving punishment. Dear children, you have to stand. We have to stand on there. You have to stand on benches. He felt that punishment was not enough and asked them to stand on their desks. Oh, my dears, here the punishment is not adequate, not enough, and you have to stand on your desks. Swaminathan was among them and felt humiliated at that eminence. Here, my dears, humiliated means, here the word is acting as a verb, humiliated, make somebody feel ashamed. Humiliated means ashaming. Sometimes some people are trying to ashamed of others. And eminence, the word eminence is acting as a noun. Here eminence means the quality of being highly accomplished and respected. But here it's a satirical. In this context, the meaning is a satirical. Then they were lectured, means the headmaster has given lecture. When it was over, they were asked to offer explanation one by one. Headmaster saying, dear children, you have to give the explanation why you were absent yesterday. One said that he had an attack of headache. And he's saying, sir, I had an attack of headache and therefore couldn't come to school. That's why, sir, I didn't come to school. This is the given answer by student. He was asked to bring a medical certificate. Yeah, our headmaster is asking, you have to bring medical certificates. The second said that while he had been coming to school on the previous day, someone had told him that there would be no school. Sir, somebody told there may be not school. There may be not school. The headmaster replied that if he was going to listen to everybody loafer who said that there would be no school, he deserved to be flagged anyway. Here another word, deserved, means, my dears, deserved is acting as a verb. Deserved is acting as a verb. Had eligibility to get something. Here I deserve or you deserve to listen to my class carefully. Next word, my dear children, flog, F-L-O-G, flog. Flog is acting as a verb, which means beat with a stick as a punishment. Beat with a stick as a punishment. So here, why did you listen to the words of loafer and why didn't come to school and verify? No answer. Master is asking seriously. Why didn't you confirm? Why didn't you verify whether the statement was right or wrong? No answer. The class is rough silent. The punishment was pronounced 10 days attendance cancelled. What was the punishment? They have to be given 10 days attendance cancelled. 2 rupees fine. 2 rupees fine. And the whole day to be spent on the desk. The third said that he had an attack of headache. Third student is giving the reply. That is an attack of a headache. The fourth said that he had a stomachache. And the fourth student is saying, sir, I had stomachache. The fifth said that his grandmother died. Suddenly, just as just as he was starting for school. While he was starting for school, his grandmother was dead. She was died. The headmaster asked him if he could bring a letter from his father. No, he had no father. No, he had no father. Then who was his guardian? Okay, father was not there. But who was his guardian? His grandmother. But grandmother was dead. She was no more. She was no more. Was she not? No, it was another grandmother. The headmaster asked, how many grandmothers a person could have? Children, how many grandfathers could have? A children, no answer. No answer. Could he bring a letter from his neighbors? Okay, was there any chance to bring a letter from his neighbors? No, he couldn't. None of his neighbors could read or write because he lived in a very illiterate part of Elliman Street. The street is fully illiterate, means non-educated. Then the headmaster offered to send a teacher to his illiterate locality to ascertain from boy's neighbors if the death of the grandmother was a fact. Here, the headmaster is supposing he is trying to send a teacher to know whether the grandmother was died or not. A pause. Some perspiration. Here, perspiration means sweat. Yeah, perspiration means sweat. Perspiration is acting. It's acting as a noun. Some perspiration, and then the answer that the neighbors couldn't possibly know anything about it since the grandmother died in the village. Here, since the grandmother was died in the village, they couldn't gather the information. They can't gather the information. The headmaster hit him on his knuckles. The headmaster hit him on his knuckles with his cane. Called him street dog. And pronounced the punishment, 15 days suspension. See how the serious punishment is given by headmaster to that student. Here, another new word we came across, that knuckles. It's acting as a noun, a part of finger at a joint where the bone is near the surface. Yes, knuckles. When Swaminathan's turn came, one by one, turning is coming. Now it's the turning of Swaminathan. He looked around helplessly. Swaminathan looked around helplessly. Rajan sat on the third bench in front and resolutely looked away. He was gazing at the blackboard intently. Yes, here another word. Already, you know the word cane. Cane is acting as a noun and it's nothing but a stem of a plant or a bamboo stick. We well known that word. Cane is nothing but a bamboo stick or it's a stem of a plant. And intently means here, intently is acting as an adverb. It means attentively. Yes, my dear children, now you are attending to the class. I mean, you are listening to the class. Attentively means intentively. With utmost interest and with utmost concentration. So he was gazing at the blackboard intently. This is the first phase situation up to here. To make more clear, to comprehend the text, my dear children, let's look at the glossary. Let's look at the glossary. I'm going to share the screen of the glossary. Let you note down the words. My dears, here glossary. It's very clear, I think. Yes, it's very clear. The glossary from A reading. Swami is expelled from school. First word, flushed. Yeah, flushed. Flushed is acting as an adjective. It means red and hot. Flushed face means red face, which is angry. Second word, my dears, ominous. Ominous is acting as an adjective. It's suggesting that something bad is going to happen. Ominous look means a peculiar look, which is indicating that something is going to be happened bad. Next word, my dears, humiliated. Yeah, humiliated. Humiliated is acting as a verb. Make somebody feel ashamed. Yeah, sometimes persons are trying to make humiliation to others. Make somebody feel ashamed. Making ashaming. Next word, eminence. Eminence is acting as a noun. Eminence is acting as a noun. The quality of being highly accomplished and respected. Actually, eminence is reflecting the quality of being highly accomplished and respected. But here means in this context, it's a satirical. It's a satirical context. Next word, my dear children, deserved. Deserved is acting as a verb. Had eligibility to get something. We have eligibility. You deserve to get a 10 by 10 in the coming examinations. You deserve to achieve an IAS. Like that. Had eligibility to get something. Deserve. Next word, my dear children, flag. Flag is acting as a verb. Beat with a stick as a punishment. Beat with a stick as a punishment. Flag. Next word, ascertain means to find out. Now we are ascertaining meanings to the new words or new vocabulary. Means finding out. Find out. Ascertain means find out. Perspiration. Perspiration is acting as a noun. Perspiration is acting as a noun here, which means sweat. Which means sweat. You know, while we are in summer days and while we are having more temperature, then we will have sweat on our body. Next word, my dear children, knuckles. Knuckles is acting as a noun. A part of finger at a joint where the bone is near to the surface. Sometimes we may try to give small punishment on knuckles of your hands. Yes, knuckles. Cane. Dear children, cane. Cane is acting as a noun. Stem of a plant or a bamboo stick. Next word, my dears, resolutely. It's acting as an adverb. Shouting great determination. Shouting great determination. Intentively. Here the word intentively is acting as an adverb. It's acting as an adverb. The meaning is attentively. The meaning is attentively means with utmost concentration. Now, my dear sir, you are listening to my class intentively. Means with attention, with concentration, with full interest. Pink ears. Pink ears. Ears that appears red when somebody is angry with. Suppose you are getting angry. And then your ears will be appeared red. Your ears will be appeared red in color. Red in color. While you got angry. While you got angry. Intolerable. next word, my dears, intolerable. Intolerable is acting as an adjective, which means unacceptable. Sometimes we have some intolerable students in our classes because they try to disturb the class, and they try to chat with others while the class is going on. So their activities are intolerable, means unacceptable, unacceptable. So intolerable, tolerable, opposite, intolerable, tolerable, adjective. It's antonym, intolerable, means unacceptable, unacceptable. Next word, acute, acute. It's acting as an adjective, which means very serious or severe, very serious or severe, acute. Example, there is acute syndrome, I mean acute fever, acute heart stroke, acute problem, means which is very serious or severe. Yes, you will use that word in that context. Acute, acute fever, now I have, for example, means a very serious fever or very severe fever. Wrap, here wrap is acting as a noun, which means severe blow with a cane. Wrap, severe blow with a cane. Next, my dear children, impulse. It's acting as a noun, sudden strong wish. It's a sudden strong wish, impulse. In this situation, suppose if you have impulse of noting down all these vocabulary clearly, it's a sudden strong wish. Another word, go. Here, G A O. G A O is acting as a noun. It's nothing but J. But it is old use, old fashioned usage. It is old fashioned usage, goal, which is indicating a jail, which is acting as a noun. Disappointed. My dears, another word, disappointed. Not communicated. Or described in a clear way. Disappointed means, suppose because of some disturbance, because of some utterances, if it's not clear, then you may use disappointed. Disappointed means it was not communicated or described in a clear way. These are a few glossary from Swami is expelled from school. From the page number 47. If we read very well this glossary, then it's very easy to comprehend. I mean, to understand the paragraphs very, very easy. So, my dears, here, we read page number 47. The headmaster and classroom situation, and what was happened yesterday. Some students were absent because of that. Headmaster got raised, I mean, he got angry, and he is supposing to give severe punishment. And then the headmaster is asking explanation one by one. After that, Swami's turn came, and then he looked around helplessly, like that. This is a context up to what we have finished. So, my dears, here once again, if you read, if you go through the vocabulary which I'm sharing on the screen.
You have to note down the glossary and read once, twice, thrice.
And again, you go through the paragraphs from page number 47. 1, 2, and 3 paragraphs now we have finished. After that, we may go for comprehensive paragraphs and for comprehensive questions. Then we are able to find the answers. Means you are able to give the answers for comprehension pages from A reading. In paper 1, we must have a paragraph from this A reading only. That's why we should take care of these paragraphs. Once again, you have to read once, twice, thrice. And then tomorrow, we are going to have comprehensive paragraphs from this page, means page number, which is 47. Yes, up to next class, you have to read glossary very well. And we have to read this text once, twice, thrice. And you try to grasp the meaning of the text. And if you get any new words other than this glossary, you have to consult the dictionary and you get the meaning. Or if it is possible, you may ask by phones to teachers. They are ready to clarify. They are ready to give equivalent synonyms and antonyms for the vocabulary. Then it will be very clear, the comprehension, and you are eligible to give the answers. So, my dear children, from this year reading, which is Swami is expelled from school. It's from our school life. At least we might have a bitter experience of this, surely, because that was a possible situation in our school life for everybody. But nowadays, we have to oppose this verbal punishment, because psychology doesn't accept this type of corporal punishment, because we have to aware of the consequences, particularly bad losses of our children, and we should not remain our children as dropouts. That is it will be become a bigger problem. So here, and if you understood this, you are ready to argue to the proposition punishment will help the students to learn. Here I'm going to point before you a proposition: punishment will help the students to learn. To support this proposition, you have to give some you have to give your opinion, and you have to give some illustrations which will support this proposition. And at the same time, some may oppose this proposition, and they have to support their they have to substance their opinion, and they have to give some illustrations which can justify their opinion, which is punishment will help the students to learn. It's a proposition I'm pointing before you. You try to write as a homework some points which will support this proposition, and some points which don't support this proposition. That is for your homework, my dear children. You have to do. And then once again, I remind you to read this page number 47 paragraphs fully. And I'm going to give, I think day after tomorrow in my next class, some paragraph questions. And in that paragraph questions, easily you are eligible to give the answers easily, while you go through these paragraphs very well, which is Swami is expelled from school. The A reading, Swami is expelled from school. Once again, I remind you to note down the glossary, means meanings, and you try to understand the contextual meaning with the help of that glossary while you go through this text. easily we can understand that context meaning, and we can comprehend the given paragraphs, and easily we will face that comprehensive questions in our examination also. After that, already I have suggested you to write a debate that proposition punishment will help the students to learn. That also it's meant for our homework. My dear children, once again I am very happy to be with you with the help of this class, and next we are going to meet day after tomorrow with the comprehensive questions, and then we will continue the completion of this. Swami is expelled from school year reading lesson. My dear children, I think you have enjoyed